Welcome to Faith and Friends. We're looking forward to spending this first week of April with you. We start a new health series this month. We'll also be bringing you the special documentary Unpopular later this month. So a lot of good things coming up in the month of April.
Today on Faith and Friends, we take you to the recent Dream On Conference at Only Believe Ministries in Botkins. We'll also share a story about drugs and children. Now, there's plenty in the news about drug addictions and how they're affecting teens and adults, but what about the effects on children?
Very interesting story there. That's very important for families. We'll start our show, however, with something also very important, the Bible. April means we're moving into the fourth spiritual workout step in our 2017 Faith Challenge, forgiving others. And Luke 17, 1 through 4 talks about forgiveness. Then he said to the disciples, "It's impossible that no offenses should come, but woe to him through whom they do come. It would be better for him if a millstone were hung around his neck and he were thrown into the sea than that he should offend one of these little ones. Take heed to yourselves. If your brother sins against you, rebuke him. And if he repents, forgive him. And if he sins against you seven times in a day, and seven times in a day returns to you saying, 'I repent,' you shall forgive him." It's not just one time. It's not just a handful of times. Doesn't matter if the person's learning their lesson or not. It is our job to forgive and to forgive and to forgive. And as the one, the offender, it's our job to repent when we do fall short or we hurt somebody. So two very important concepts there.
It can be hard to forgive someone who isn't repentant.
Very much so.
Yeah.
Well, certainly in the time it takes to finish this sentence, 53 more prescriptions for opioids were just filled in the United States. The extensive use and abuse of prescription opioids has been called an epidemic in this country. And while the problem in adults has received a lot of news coverage, there's been very little coverage about the effects on children. But as Clark Powell shows in this week's OIO Community segment, a new study is shedding light on the issue.
Pharmacies fill more than 650,000 prescriptions for opioids each day in this country.
Central Iowa Poison Center.
And increasingly, calls are coming into poison control hotlines because of them.
In this study, we found that poison control centers in the United States receive a call every 45 minutes for a child that's been exposed to opioid medications.
That study was conducted by researchers at the Center for Injury Research and Policy and the Central Ohio Poison Center at Nationwide Children's Hospital. It analyzed calls to U.S. poison control centers between 2000 and 2015 and found a sharp increase related to opioids initially, but a drop since 2009, with one notable exception.
We saw a pretty significant increase among young children getting into medications that are used to treat opioid dependence. Buprenorphine in particular had a significant increase in exposures to young children.
Drugs like buprenorphine or Suboxone are especially dangerous. They are primarily used to help people addicted to heroin or other opioids, but they can be dangerous if they get into the hands of children.
When children get exposed to buprenorphine, if mom or dad sees it happening and they take the pill out of the child's mouth, the child can still go into a coma and stop breathing many hours later.
Experts are calling for increased prevention efforts to better protect children, including changes in how these pills are packaged. Instead of loose pills in bottles, they suggest increased use of blister packs or single dose packaging like this.
Keep these things up, away, and out of sight, preferably in a locked location so they can't get access to them.
At Nationwide Children's Hospital, this is Clark Powell reporting.
The last Saturday in March brought dreamers from across the country to Botkins, Ohio for the first annual Dream On Conference. The event was held at Only Believe Ministries and featured four main session speakers, including the former lead singer of Sanctus Real, Matt Hammett. There were breakout sessions involving how to pursue the dreams God's given you in sports or adoption, how to pursue dreams as a family, and in missions. Hundreds of people were encouraged to not just chase a dream, but to chase a God who will lead them. Derek Johnson from Jesus Culture closed the night in worship as many were impacted by a day focused on discerning and following God's plan for their lives.
We've been planning this for about a year. We have an amazing team, a core group of volunteers who've helped us the last year, and everybody who's helped us the day of. It's just like anything in life. If you don't involve others, you typically can't get it done. So we're very thankful for all our volunteers. It's been amazing. The conference it was a success from the first second, you know, just how God put everything together. And really been hearing some great stories about how people's, even from just the first session, just how Jimmy Needham brought the word, and it was just an impactful message. And so I feel really good. I really think that this will be a changing moment in people's lives, this conference, and it'll be something that they're constantly looking forward to every year, as kind of that re-sparking, that catalyst that they need to keep moving forward.
Transitioning from one important health topic to another, all throughout the month of April and 2 weeks into May, we're bringing you the series Fully Alive. What is your energy level? How are your reactions to difficult situations? Are your joints aching? Are you struggling some days just to go on? Well, answering yes to any of those or several other questions can point to a myriad of possible health ailments. Donna Krech explains from personal experience that these symptoms could be the precursors to some serious health problems. But the good news is, it's not too late for you to make the proper adjustments so you can live fully alive.
They told her the next phase was death. What would you think if you got a message like that? Well, today we're going to start a multi-week series where we talk with Donna Krech and some of her friends about how God can do amazing things to change health. It happened to her, it happened to her friends, and you know what? It could also happen to you as well. Donna, thank you so much for joining us on Faith and Friends as we get ready to talk about a really important subject.
Understatement. because what people don't know is that God intended us to feel fantastic until the day we leave this planet. But nobody tells us that. And then nobody tells us how. As a matter of fact, what we're told is, well, you know, you are getting older. And it's hogwash. It's just not true, but it's what we're conditioned to believe. It doesn't have to be that way. But I think no one knows what these feeling lousy things mean. There is a reason they're occurring. It's not just that they're occurring. And by feeling lousy things, I mean like your body is hurting. There's pain. Your joints are hurting, or you just have pain throughout. You can't sleep. You've got acid reflux, or you've got digestive disorders, or you've got headaches, or your vision is changing. I mean, that's a big one, right? People go, well, no, that's just part of getting older. No, that's actually coming back to a hormone imbalance. Mm. So people don't know. And boy, do they not know that a hormone imbalance and feeling lousy can actually keep you from losing weight. It can cause you unexplained weight gain, even if you're doing everything right. So yeah, this is, it's life-changing stuff. Now, our members tell us life-saving stuff, but our team claims at the very minimum life-changing stuff. And we wouldn't be doing it if I hadn't lived through my story.
So Donna just mentioned some very common health issues that may affect you, one, two, or several of them. We hear about them all the time across our country. Diagnoses are being made every single day on how to treat each one individually. But let's take a look at it as a whole, and let's listen to Donna's story as she talks about not just what happened to her, but how those symptoms, she saw great improvement in what happened to her, but also how it could mean changes for you. Donna, let's go ahead and start. Tell me a little bit of your story.
Okay, well, with your permission, you have said that I can share part of an article that I wrote. So I'm going to start the story by just one paragraph out of the article. And of course, if our viewer wants a copy of this, we'll be happy to get them the whole
thing. And you can always contact us.
There we go. Perfect. Okay, so here's just one paragraph that I'll extract, and then I'll elaborate. That's okay. I was told I might die. A memory that will be forever burned on my brain is of my children sitting with me as I told them. I was so weak, I couldn't operate a hand can opener. I was so exhausted, I literally could barely lift my head. The pain that ran through my body was indescribable. I missed a lot of things that matter to me. I had to say no to family time, events where help was needed, church functions, and travel. I vividly remember lying on my couch, sobbing, knowing I was missing time with people I loved. But also because the thoughts running through my mind were, is this it? Am I really dying? Are these years all I get, and have I made these years matter? As tears poured, my body felt like I was 90, and my spirit felt a heaviness I want no one to ever experience ever. I felt beaten. I was in a state of illness followed by depression that I can't find words for.
That's a very heavy paragraph.
That's a very heavy paragraph.
Wow.
When you open this segment.
And that's real.
is rule.
That really happened to you, and you really experienced all of that.
When you opened the segment with, they told her the next phase was death, it was kind of overwhelming. I tell my own story, and I can say it, but when I hear somebody else say it, I remember how real it was when he said it to me. Now listen, again, our viewer, you and I, have had these conversations. People just keep going. We just keep going. We don't feel so great, but we just keep going. It's the way we're made. And I had some colds, or I had some what seemed to be infections bronchially, or I'd just be kind of laid up a few days feeling achy, thinking it was flu-like. And that happened over a couple years. Now, my background's exercise, right? Mm-hmm. And exercise fixes everything, right? she said somewhat sarcastically, because that's what I believed. So when I didn't feel good or I felt kind of run down, I would exercise, because exercise fixes everything. Well, over a period of a couple of years, I would get worse, and these times of not feeling well would get closer and closer together. And we were making some changes with our program at Total Solution, and I had begun working with different experts around the country, sex hormone experts, and moved into psychologists, and moved into OBGYNs, and I was moving into stress hormone experts. So this was all very quote-unquote coincidental. Not. There are no coincidences. God's got it all planned, right? So as I'm working with a stress hormone expert, I'm starting to learn of questions to ask our members that are making my ears perk up. And as we're talking, he's picking up some of what I'm saying that I'm going through. And he says, Donna, I think we needed to do a couple tests. I think you're dealing with some adrenal stuff. I think you've got some cortisol problems. Now, when stress rises, cortisol rises. And we all have stress. Mm-hmm. So we've all got some cortisol issues going on, and that's gonna make all the other hormones go out of balance. Now, again, symptoms. As I mentioned, I was so weak, literally, I could not turn. Not that it was slow to turn a hand can opener, I couldn't do it. There wasn't strength to turn the hand can opener. Couldn't lift my head, I was exhausted. Yet, I would wake up in the middle of the night 2, 3, 4 hours. Couldn't go back to sleep. My brain was so foggy, I couldn't remember anything. I mean, I started to get scared. I went to a test. Listen, every test, poke, prod, x-ray you can have, I had. And I went to a test to see if I had the onset of Alzheimer's. I was terrified. Now, I'm a big one on as a man thinks, so is he, right? And out of the abundance of the heart, right, a man speaks. So I wouldn't say these words out loud to very many people, but as time went on, I was more and more scared. I got to the point where my gums would bleed. Now, not when I flossed or when I brushed, but sitting here talking to you, blood would begin running down my teeth. That was terrifying. And my hair was falling out in chunks. My skin itched so bad that I scratched it off to the point where I had huge scratch marks where blood had oozed. I mean, it was just bad. And like I said, I remember being on my couch and beginning to cry because the fear was starting to overtake me that he told me the next phase was death. Now, it can start with adrenal exhaustion, which is usually where it says, adrenal fatigue. Mm-hmm. It's pretty light. You probably won't even notice it. Adrenal exhaustion, you may notice some symptoms. Adrenal burnout, and the end of adrenal burnout is where I was. The next phase was adrenal failure. Well, adrenal failure equals death. You can't function. And what I realized after I observed all these symptoms, and now I'm working with the stress hormone expert, so we're working very closely, and there are many other symptoms that we haven't talked about here, what I realized is my body was shutting down. My body was going into the dying mode. Now, what I also found out is this is not uncommon, but most folks don't get to the place where I was, right? And as most folks go through this journey, their symptoms are being labeled as something other than what they might be. Now, again, I'm not gonna profess I'm a doctor. I'm not. Mm-hmm. I'm not gonna say I can cure anything. I couldn't say that if I wanted to. But what I have is my own story, and now what I have are thousands and thousands of stories from members who we've taught this information to, and their life is changing. It goes back to the root. Why don't you feel well, or why do you feel this symptom? And it's amazing to see how these things can be repaired. I mean, I feel great, and I didn't feel great.
You're sitting here today as an example of back to life. So you are an example of the reality that regardless of where you are, if this describes you by any chance, it's not too late. But I think there's an important thing where this was discovered in your life at the worst stage. Is it possible to find people in an earlier stage and help them get out of it?
Yes.
Quickly?
Yes. Yes, yes, yes. The good news is yes. So the first thing I would share is we have an adrenal questionnaire that, again, we'll gift to anybody that wants it. And this is a subjective test, obviously, but at least it's got some questions.
And before we get there, tell us how they can get in touch with you.
Okay. We're going to offer my assistant's email address, which is Elisha@DonnaKrech.com.
Okay.
It's E-L-I-S-H-A, Elisha, at DonnaKrech.com. Or a person could go to 2030fasttrack.com. It will look like it's just a weight loss wellness thing, but if you opt in there, this will be part of what you get. So either way, and the questions on here are the first step to take to determine. And there are questions like, do you experience problems falling asleep, staying asleep? Do you find yourself needing caffeine in the morning or in the afternoon? I won't go through them because, again, we'll gift them. But beyond then the subjective test, there is a cortisol test, a saliva test that can be taken. And that will pinpoint exactly not only where you are with cortisol levels, but cortisol levels also affect the sex hormones. So it will pinpoint where you are with, for women, progesterone, estrogen, men, testosterone, estrogen, and it will show you why you may be having the symptoms that you're having. Again, God intended us to feel fantastic till the day we leave the planet, but nobody's telling us that, and nobody's telling us how. So what's interesting is I think a disappointment can be a divine appointment, and I think that's what I went through. I think it was my disappointment lying there on that couch wondering how on earth somebody is pretty big, full of energy that I am, could be in this place. And the reason I believe it was a divine appointment is because we wouldn't have shifted everything we do in our nationwide company to serve people in this way if I hadn't realized that this was the culprit to virtually every health symptom. And again, weight loss or the inability to lose weight or weight gain, we never would have known that over 35, specifically over 35 years of age, this is the stuff that's happening. It's hormone imbalance. And I lived through it so that God could use me, right? To say, oh my gosh, you can feel amazing. You can be well. You can be whole. And well, that's why we're calling this Fully Alive. Because we don't help people lose weight. We don't help people even be well. We help them learn how to live fully alive.
Fully alive. That is what God has desired for you. He wants you to be fully alive. So we're talking about hormonal issues. We're talking about tiredness. We're talking about achiness. We're talking about stress. We're talking about mind fog. All of these symptoms that individually might seem like one thing, but is it worth it to stop and think, am I having hormonal issues? Am I having adrenal issues? And a free assessment certainly is a good way to get the starting point to see what could happen. As you look back, we're just about out of time for this first segment, but as you look back, Donna, and you realize the struggles that you went through, I mean, I'm sure you can't look back at lying on the couch and go, oh, that was fun. That was a vacation.
It's terrifying.
I enjoyed it.
It's terrifying.
But now that you can look at your life now and you can feel how you're living compared to how you were living before, describe the difference.
So, you know, I really kind of always was proud of myself for a little slogan I created years ago, and that's life's short, don't miss a minute of it. I thought I got it. I didn't get it until I went through this. And now I really, it's my goal, it's my priority every day to live full, to realize life is short. And you know what? There's a possibility I might not wake up tomorrow. Why invest time in being mad? Why invest time in being bitter? Let me look to the things that I can do today that helps somebody else's day be amazing, which also then helps my day be amazing. That's what's really changed. I'll check myself. If I get into that mode that's not so positive, which we can all do, or reactive, which we can all do, competitive, which we can all do, and I'll stop and go, whoa, do you really want to invest your time in this? It shifts things. It makes hormones healthier, by the way, to shift that mindset. Mm-hmm. So it all works together.
This is just the beginning of the story, because God truly does want us to live fully alive. Here's where you can get more information about the things Donna has shared so far. 419-224-8446. That website is 2030fasttrack.com. And there is the address where you can just show up and say, hey, I got to know more about this, because this is you're describing my life, and I know that God has a better plan for me. Well, Donna, thank you so much for beginning your story. We look forward to the coming weeks sharing more of your story, because God has done great things through you, and he wants to do the same things through so many other people.
Thank you so much.
Donate your car, boat, motorcycle, or mower to the TV 44 auction. You'll benefit from a tax deduction, but more importantly, you'll be part of the ministry of TV 44. Call today to find out more.
You have a little trophy.
I have a little trophy. You know what? You bring us the biggest car for the auction, and we'll give you this. We'll give you something better than this trophy. Actually, this year's TV 44 auction is still about 5 months away, but already donations are arriving, so we welcome them from you. And today we'll play our first game of auction item. Can you guess it? We're missing Ben, who is our incredible auction item.
He
can you guess
the,
it?
The
host.
Game, yeah.
So this will not be quietly nearly as.
Energetic,
being showy.
Energetic, but don't forget that all of the auction items in today's game will be a part of our trips auction, so you can come in September and you can bid on them. All three have been included in the past year of the auction, and here are the rules of the game. Are you ready, gentlemen?
Yes.
Should we close our eyes?
I will give you several clues.
Not looking.
For each trip location. The person who guesses the most will win this trophy. We have three, so we're looking for the best two out of three, and we're going for the prize.
Ready.
Andy's getting in the zone. The trophy.
Where's my buzzer?
You better watch out. You've got a competitor going here.
I'm aware of my competitor and aware of his shortcomings.
Mark will be okay.
All right, here we go. Item number one. They typically live in the wild. You won't get out of the car here, but you will. These things will come to you. It's kind of like a zoo.
A feral cat park?
You are wrong.
Does that mean he's eliminated? Or can he keep guessing? We need more rules.
You can keep guessing. You can keep guessing.
It's a zoo of some sort.
It is a zoo of some sort.
Almost like a safari.
Ding, 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 ding. It's the African Wildlife Safari, which Pastor Damien Tibbs taking his family there and says it is a great place. And we have tickets for up to 16 people.
16 people? What kind of car are you taking up there?
We have two eight-people passes. So
those aren't just any passes. Those are VIP passes.
That's true. VIP passes. The giraffe may lick your face.
Because he's riding with you, right? You get a special giraffe.
Now, has the giraffe given birth to the baby yet? Is that passed
not at this
on the
place.
Internet yet?
I believe... I don't know enough to give you an accurate answer.
Are we on Panda Watch day 123?
You know what? If you go up to the African Safari Wildlife Park, you may not see a giraffe giving birth, but you will see a giraffe. You may see the ugliest warthog and a whole lot more.
The ugliest warthog.
The ugliest warthog.
Okay. I didn't realize we were putting value judgments on the beauty of warthogs and other wild animals.
All right, let's move on in our game. Item number two. Mm. This is an interactive science museum, primarily for kids.
TV
44. Still very interesting to adults.
Is it TV 44?
Andy, you're just... This trophy is moving a little closer to Mark all the time. It's very hands-on. If you are a toddler, you can spend an entire afternoon playing in the water. Hmm. Exhibits for the older adults include topics like big machines, the human body, lab experiment opportunities.
Almost as if you want to make something or create something.
That's true. Getting closer. Anybody have an answer?
Oh, I've got an answer. I'm trying to make this out of a game.
The Creation Museum? That's what... No.
You have not taken your kids here?
To TV 44 often.
This is a...
The Creation Museum?
This is un-Ohioan to not take your children to this museum.
Cosi?
At least 1 point. Ah, you got it!
Right.
Cosi, it's 1-1. Okay, guys, this is it. This is the final tiebreaker to determine who's going to win this awesome trophy. Okay, our final item in this week's auction game, can you guess it? Might make you think about mountains, but it only offers big hills, but they're good hills. However, these big hills offer a lot of thrills, whether you are going down in a donut-shaped contraption or flying down with two long flat things attached to your feet.
Could this be some sort of geological formation that might be considered unstable or unhappy?
I have a feeling that Mark is just playing with us and really knows the answer.
He's going mad.
Perhaps.
In a river.
In a river. There. I don't think you're going to be in a river.
If you go far enough.
Mad river. If you go far enough. You missed your chance, Mark. I know you knew the answer, and he just said it. That's being a kind person, letting the other
person. I will give my trophy to him.
You just broke
my trophy! That hard-made
and
plastic.
And that's why we can't have a real trophy.
Hey, but you can have a real trip to Mad River Mountain because we do have tickets donated for this year's auction, and it will be available the first Saturday after Labor Day. We certainly hope that you join us for this year's TV 44 auction.
And they're
auction.
Good for next winter.
That's right. Okay. These are good for the 2017-2018 season,
that's
and
helpful.
They are good for 3 hours of tubing.
And of course, your auction donations are being accepted now. You can bring your donations to TV 44 Tuesday through Thursdays, 10 a.m. to 3 p.m. We also accept monetary donations designed specifically towards auction purchases. Call us with any questions at 419-339-4444.
Certainly excited for that. Auction time is a fun time, and donating to the TV 44 auction is just one way that you can help TV 44 in its ministry. Spring to Life is another.
That's right. The Spring to Life campaign is underway now. Hopefully you've already had a chance to see some of our thank you spots that are airing with certain programs. Our goal is to raise $70,000 between now and May 14th. And we still have a ways to go. We're really just in the beginning. We've barely even raised about $10,000. So any donation that you give us makes us one step closer to that goal.
During the Spring to Life campaign, would you be willing to keep TV 44 in prayer? Additionally, if you've been considering donating to TV 44 but haven't, now's a great time as we prepare in advance to broadcast through the summer months. To donate online, visit WTLW.com, or you can donate by phone at 419-339-4444, and in person or by mail at 1844 Beatty Road, right here in Lima, Ohio, 45807.
Time now for one more look at our scripture. We're focusing on the practice of forgiving others in our faith challenge topic for the month of April. And that's what leads us to Luke chapter 17, verses 1 and 4. Then he said to the disciples, "It is impossible that no offenses should come, but woe to him through whom they do come. It would be better for him if a millstone were hung around his neck and he were thrown into the sea than that he should offend one of these little ones. Take heed to yourselves. If your brother sins against you, rebuke him, and if he repents, forgive him. And if he sins against you seven times in a day, and seven times in a day returns to you, saying, 'I repent,' you shall forgive him." Certainly we'll forgive Jennifer for dropping and losing our trophy.
Yes, you're forgiven. Doesn't it feel good?
Really does. It does. It's actually lost, too, so we have two issues going on now.
We forgive you for that, too.
April 10th marks the first day of Passover, which means Monday night at sundown begins the annual 8-day remembrance commemorating the emancipation of the Israelites from slavery in ancient Egypt. It is observed by avoiding leaven and highlighted by the Seder meals that includes retelling the story of Exodus. In Hebrew, it is known as the Pesach, which means to pass over, because God passed over the Jewish homes when killing the Egyptian firstborn on the very first Passover Eve. We close today's show by taking you to the land of Israel. Zach Waller of the ministry HaYovel brings us the original song, Redemption. And while it's not written specifically to talk about Passover, the idea of Christ's redemption can be seen not just in the emancipation of the Israelites from slavery, but every single day we have the forgiveness of sins and a chance for a new life. Here now is Redemption.
2,000 years of desolation, God forsaken, barren land, a people scattered out in the nations, generations. Foreign land. Where is the God of Israel?